impressive as always.
Felix!
by verity, by strength. What are we contemplating today?
Backpack.
I knew you were much for tossball, Max.
I see I've graduated from Vic to Max. Wonderful.
What with being a church man? Don't it take the fun out of tossball if the winner is predetermined by the law?
The only thing that takes the fun out...
If you'll just listen...
No! No more listening. No more preaching. We are losing people left and right. We need to act.
Enough, Zora. I'm not putting the torch to innocent people. Do you want to bring the board's cruisers and gunships down on us? Captain, apologies, but our situation grows dire. Our people talk of foolish endeavors. What news do you bring? Excellent.
Did you find the Vanois? Lucky indeed. Thank you.
We're one step closer to bringing the truth to every man, woman, and child in Halcyon. This plan's brilliance is in its subtlety. For the time being, let us cease our activities on the tower, lest we bring premature attention upon us. I have much to do, articles to write, sermons to ponder. We live in such an exciting time. Let's talk later.
Hey, I need to see to the wounded, but drop by the clinic when you can. I want a word.
Hey, Captain. I need your help, and we ought to keep it hush-hush. You know about what happened here, right? The history of Amber Heights?
I read about this in Thrilling Tales of the Frontier. Pirates raided Amber Heights. It was a real bloodbath.
Right. Common belief is that the pirates fled to an old relay station that had already been abandoned, but nobody could find them. The station's locked up, but one of my people found an old data cartridge in a nearby rat nest. It's mostly corrupted, but I pulled a couple codes off of it. One is the code to the Amber Heights gate. I don't recognize the other, but it's similar. I bet it opens a door. Right. The access codes to Amber Heights. What gets me is, if this belonged to the pirates, that means they knew someone there. If someone gave them the gate code, all those deaths, Captain, all that blood is on their hands. I know it's a long shot, but if we miss something there, if you can get into that station, maybe we can get some answers. Graham isn't fond of talking about the history here. He had friends who worked here. The massacre hit him pretty hard. You know him. Live and let live and all that. I don't want to burden him right now, especially if this ends up being a dead end. I surely do, but it's not far. And if they died in there, they died with their munitions. We'll need them. Besides, if it's filled with valuables from the aristocrats who lived here, we can pawn them off on Sublight and get ourselves ahead on our food budget. Just a warning. The area is infested with mantisaurs. I'd send some help, but we're, you know, preparing for war. Appreciate it. Here's the code. If it works, bring back anything you find. Supplies are best, but information's good too. If someone was behind the Amber Heights massacre, it'd give a lot of people around here some closure to find out who and string them up. Good luck. Watch out for the Taros.
All the wrist.
Thornburg was off bounds. That's the only reason the Darlings won.
Thornburg was well within bounds. The Darlings won because the Rangers have no defense.
Welcome back. You find anything out there? Let's see. These are old. Looks like correspondences between the pirates. Some bits here, some there, some... Wait. This one's got the Amber Heights gate code on it, just like the one I found earlier. And here's... a letter. Wait, this is from Graham. Oh, of all the... Captain, he gave them the gate codes. Watch it. That's our leader you're talking about. My friend. I know he's got his head in the clouds, but I always believed there was a core of good there. What the hell happened to live and let live?
Always figured Mr. Bryant for a man of character. In the end, though, he was just another name on a long list of frauds.
Yeah. He had us all fooled. Now I've got to sort out how to break it to the rest of my people. Thank you for bringing this back, but I need some time. I gotta think. I'll let you know if I figure something out.
You got a second?
I can't believe I wanted to shake his hand. I need a shower. It makes you wonder if being a treacherous, two-timing coward is some sort of contagious disease, or if he was just born that way. At first, I liked what Graham was doing. The iconoclasts were going to change Halcyon for the better. But then, we found out Graham was behind the slaughter of Amber Heights. How can anybody so morally bankrupt lead a movement to transform the colony? Yeah, maybe you're right. You'd never do something like that, would you? Slaughter a whole community of innocents? Yeah, that's what I thought. Let's get back to it. I need to put all this ugly business with Graham behind me.
Go take a walk, Captain. I'll find you once my head's on straight.
Be careful with your new friends in Amber Heights. They're not the most reliable types. Anyway, what can I do for you?
You weren't supposed to look. I asked you to delete it. I didn't mean for any harm to come to you.
This has been my albatross, the great shame of my career. I give MSI everything. My work, my youth, my left kidney, and for years, I was a joke to them. Oh, perhaps they were right. After all, what have I built? Stellar Bay is barely keeping afloat.
Thank you.
I hadn't thought of it that way. But perhaps there's something to that. Thank you for that. Was there something else? Oh, yes. I'm going to be up all night with this. All those blanks waiting to be filled, boxes waiting to be ticked.
Try to control yourself, sir.
Have you any idea how powerful this is? Corporations have been toppled with less. What a question! Bureaucratic micromanagement is the only way anything gets done in Halcyon, and proper documentation is a key part of that. For our part, a bill of liquidation slash transfer Form 52 will protect our holdings on Monarch by temporarily assigning them to a pass-through entity once we drop our bomb on the board. Corporate espionage. How was that, Celia? Did I sell it?
Your best delivery yet, sir.
I have reason to believe that one of the other corporations is operating on Monarch, illegally and in secret.
The board just can't let Monarch go, huh?
If we can find proof, I can use that as leverage to encourage certain powers that be to accept our Bolt 52 and reinstate us on the board. If someone is operating here, then Catherine's almost certainly supplying them out of Fallbrook. Perhaps she could be convinced to tell you where they are. That's part of the problem. She has certain ambitions for Stellar Bay, and I fear my asking her would give her the leverage she's been looking for.
Don't get yourself worked up, sir. It's perfectly natural to have a healthy fear of her.
We really don't need to discuss this now, Celia. Once you, subtly work out where this corporate facility might be, bring back proof of its operation. Maybe some nice letterhead. Or someone working there. That would do it. I knew you were the right person for the job. I suppose I'll leave you to it.
You seen Arthur today?
How's Clive? I do hope you gave him my regards. How's Clive? I do. Sure. What about it? Aside from the fact that I can smell it all the way from here. You mean you can't just follow the step? Once you're clear of the bridge, Sure. Might be I know something about it. Might be someone hired my crew to blind drop supplies on the northern bridge. Might be they sure as shit weren't pirates. Now that I consider it, I ain't heard from my delivery team in far too long. Find them for me, and I'll pay you handsomely. And I'll thank you kindly.
Initiating greetings protocol. Greetings.
Thank you.
Work 4 to 5. Thank you. place smells worse than the Batcave.
All right, pushing up.
the last of them. Watch out, Captain!
Hello there. A word, if I may be so bold? Well now, here I thought those Mantisaurs had peacefully exited the premises. But you're a simpler explanation. Thanks for the assistance. Name's Weston. Every once in a while, I set up shop along these here roads. You find yourself in need of resupply, you come on by. Care to purchase a thing or two?
Looks like they were ambushed.
None of them survived. That's what fixers call deductive.
Stay back. I may be wounded, but I'm still armed.
How'd you get past my traps anyway?
Well, you don't gotta be mean about it. What are you doing out here anyway? That feels a mite better. Wish I had something to give you, but I gnawed through my last Spratwurst an hour ago. A cave like this makes a handy place to store goods or hide out for a spell. And the traps usually keep gawkers out. Nice to know she cares. Catherine had us making drops for some big-shot client out here. And before you ask, I don't know who they are. Or were. The whole point of making drops in the middle of nowhere was to keep their identity and whereabouts a secret. Yeah. I guess the Marauders noticed because they were waiting for us. Blew the bridge and took off with the goods. Last I saw, they were heading back up the hill. You'll see it on the right when you get out of here. If you got the sand to go after him, I'm sure Catherine can reward you for your trouble. Me? I'm headed back to Fallbrook just as soon as I've caught my breath.
Great work.
We were destined to prevail.
Please.
don't have to do this. Just let us down from here. The humidity is really uncomfortable.
Shh.
I didn't mean what I said about your outfit. It's very fashionable, I swear.
Bystanders, does this make us complicit?
Thank you.
staying out of sight.
Hey, Cass. Knock, knock.
How's Clive? I do hope you gave him my regards. Fast, efficient, eager to please? Might be I should ask you for more favors. Guessing your services don't come cheap. Still, this ought to compensate for your troubles. And take an aromatic. You stink like Sisty Pig. I'll presume you mean Arthur, the one you sent scurrying back like a sprat with his tail cut off. Reckon I'm happy he's alive. I'd be happier if the marauders who botched my drop were dead.
know, Vic, you're starchier than a Spectrum potato, but you got a mean left hook, and I respect that.
Thanks, I think. Guess I could give you some pointers.
Yeah?
I'm drinking here. Move yourself on. Nothing on this moon for nobody. There's a lot of heartbreak. You know, a tiny part, a damn stupid part of me, hoped he was still out there. What happened? Damn. Well, you find our box of memories? Well, ain't you clever? Fine. I was supposed to pick him up that night. Thing is, another offer came along. Bit more lucrative. Surely ain't. But it'll buy me some better ones. Look, I like your gumption. I was gonna share the bits, but here's a couple extra. Now go on. Leave an old man to his past.